water. There's not a single day that goes by that we don't use it. And yet, most of us, well, we really don't think twice about it. We brush our teeth, we flush a toilet, and make a cup of coffee. And that's all usually within the first hour of just being awake. Without water, life on Earth would not exist. We would not exist. In fact, did you know that our planet is made up of 71% water? And you and I and, well, every other human on this planet, we're not too far behind. Our bodies are comprised of almost 60% water. So next time you take that drink or a rainstorm interrupts your plans, maybe give a little thank you, because that is the miracle of life. That is the reason that we exist. Have you ever wondered what happens to the rain after a massive storm? Or maybe even the snow from your favorite sled riding hill after all the snow melts? Well, at any given moment, our planet is covered in water, whether it be in the form of snow or rain. But once it hits the Earth or it melts, where does all that water go? Well, a portion of it returns back into the atmosphere through a process called evapotranspiration. Now, I know what you're thinking, that's a big fancy scientific word. But really all that means is that the water is transferred back from the land and into the atmosphere as a gas. But that only accounts for some portion of the water. What about the remainder of it? Well, that water is about to begin a journey of a lifetime. Today we're visiting the beautiful Oxbow Eco Center, one of the many nature preserves here in St. Lucie County. While many preserves are chosen based on the land and terrestrial habitats, Oxbow was selected as a nature preserve in an effort to protect the St. Lucie River. But with over 220 acres, why protect all of this land? Why not just protect the river itself? Well, the water in the St. Lucie River actually begins its journey elsewhere. And today, you and I have the unique opportunity to follow some of this water before it enters the St. Lucie River. Shall we get started? Let's go. At this very moment, it appears to be quite dry. But a single rain event, that could change everything. After a rainstorm, water has two options. It can either succumb to gravity and percolate or be absorbed through the ground, or if the ground is already fully saturated, the water will puddle above land and travel across ground to the lowest point. And right here at the Oxbow, that lowest point is the St. Lucie River. As we continue to follow the journey of water, you'll notice that we began to transition from a pine uplands down into an area of lower elevation. And as I walk along, you'll notice the decline in elevation. And although it's not drastic, it's enough to dictate how water flows into these low-lying environments. So after the rain falls and begins to move across the land from high areas like the pine flatwoods, it moves into lower lying areas just like this natural tributary here on the Oxbow Preserve. Now this water, it may look stagnant, it may look more like a swamp, but this water is in fact moving at a very slow rate towards the St. Lucie River. Now environments like this are critical for wildlife and plants. It's during the dry season when other locations begin to dry up that areas like this tributary remain wet or at least moist so the animals can survive through extreme dry periods.
So we've made our way to this water system, and at first glance, it sort of looks like a natural river or a swamp, but it's actually a man-made canal. And one of the ways that we know that is because it has a very straight line, almost as though it was cut or dredged. Also, right behind us are culverts and a road. Well, the main purpose of this canal, and many other ones that are similar to it, is that it helps with flood control. Now, the water that ends up in this canal is storm water runoff. In other words, this is where the water collects that travels over our parking lots, our driveways, and even our roads.
One of the most amazing characteristics about water is that it has the ability to dissolve and carry different materials along with it. So that's the same reason why trees are able to get vital minerals and nutrients from the base of their roots all the way up to the top of the trees into their leaves.
But that's not always a good thing. In the case of stormwater runoff, sometimes water carries with it harmful nutrients and chemicals. Things like fertilizers and pesticides from our lawns or golf courses or even farmlands. And that water, well, it eventually ends up in places like this canal and ultimately into the St. Lucie River and then into the Atlantic Ocean.
So this structure directly behind me is actually called a weir. And while it may look like a dam, it actually functions a tad bit different. So the main purpose of a weir is to actually slow down the water coming from the canal. And so the reason why we want to slow the water down is because with that stormwater runoff coming from our drains and our roads and our parking lots, there's a lot of those pollutants traveling through this canal. So by slowing down this water, you're actually allowing some of those chemicals and excess nutrients to settle to the bottom where the plants can utilize it before it travels through this tributary and onward into the St. Lucie River. So as we continue our journey, we're following the same exact water that I'm standing in right now that we had just seen up at the canal flowing over the weir. In fact, if we continue following the stream, we're just a few minutes away from entering the St. Lucie River. And that river eventually will join with the Indian River Lagoon and flow out the St. Lucie River right into the Atlantic Ocean. Now, you may look at this water and see that it's a little bit brown. And a lot of people think that that means the water is dirty. Well, that's actually not the case. The water is slightly brown, but it's also clear. And the reason the water is brown is because of all of this leaf and forest around us. So just like using tea bags to make tea, whenever it rains, the water passes through all of this leaf litter and debris. It actually picks up those tannic colors and it washes into this river, creating that light brown color. All right, so I don't know about you guys, but I want to see where this water goes. So let's continue following it until we reach the St. Lucie River, shall we? So after a full day of following the water, we have finally arrived at the St. Lucie River. Now, we definitely took the more difficult path by following the water, but if you're interested in seeing the St. Lucie River for yourself, there's a number of marked trails here at the Oxbow Eco Center that lead right to the edge of the water. So it has been an absolute treat to follow the water through the Oxbow watershed and end up at the beautiful St. Lucie River. It's also provided us with a wonderful reminder of our connection to waterways. Each decision we make in our own homes can have a lasting impact on waterways both near and far. So to keep our waterways healthy, we can follow local fertilizer ordinances, we can keep our grass clippings in our yards because those act as natural fertilizers, and we can also pick up after our pet waste. And while this is the end of our journey, the journey of the St. Lucie River continues onward and into the Atlantic Ocean. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you guys had just as much fun following the journey of water through the Oxbow Eco Center. And I encourage all of you to come here for yourselves and to follow the water to the St. Lucie River. This is one of the prized gems in all of St. Lucie County.